There it is, the fifth one today, folks. We made it. Mission Concepcion. This one seems to be about the closest one to downtown San Antonio. Look at, there's a photo shoot. Huh? Yeah. Let's take a picture of that girl getting her picture taken. She looks like a very beautiful señorita. There's my beautiful señorita. This looks like maybe an old Catholic school or something here. And then this looks like maybe a church that they're not using anymore. It's missing windows. Got a bunch of stuff that's broken. And then this looks like part of another old parochial school next door. So somebody told us if you go in the back, you can actually go inside this mission, so we're going to try that now. Oops, sorry.
San Antonio is a very historical city. We have very strict regulations. We're over 300 years old. We have very strict regulations that we don't restore anything in these five Spanish missions here. We could recolor, we could rebuild walls, all kinds of things, but we don't do that, otherwise we would lose their authenticity. They're all stand in the documentation of 300 years ago. Even the doors, the hinges, the locks, and the nails are all there. Missions in California, Arizona, New Mexico have all been reconstructed and rebuilt. These five have been reconstructed. That's why they designated them as World Heritage Sites. They're up there with the Taj Mahal, Egyptian Pyramids, Seven Wonders of the World. Now, I tell the history of the missions here. Very important to know history, otherwise, you come in, go out, really don't know why we have these five missions established here, nowhere else in the United States. So close together, they're all within a mile to 3 miles apart. The missions in California, Arizona, and New Mexico were built as singular missions, very far apart. And they were built, those missions were built 30 years after. These were built right here. These were built in the early 1700s. Those were built in the late 1700s. This was the main entry point for the Spanish to come in. No other place in the southwestern part of what is today the United States had yet been explored. This was it right here. I tell tell the history, but it takes about half an hour to tell the complete history. If you don't have the time for that, there is a phenomenon that occurs in this church that does not occur in any other church in the entire world but here. And I have a 30-second video and a picture to show, and that takes about 10 to 15 minutes to tell. So it's up to you if you'd like to listen to the whole thing or just 10 to 15 minutes, just let me know, and I'll tell you.
Sure.
For the Spanish to come in. You see, after the destruction of the Aztec Empire by Hernan Cortes in 1521, Hernan Cortes was to arrive in this area right here. The Spanish chose Texas as their main exploration point in 1521. Why? Because the French had already started their empire in what is today Louisiana and Mississippi. So the Spanish wanted to explore this area to keep them out. Otherwise, the French would have claimed a huge amount of land in this area. So the Spanish arrived here in 1521 in what is today the state of Texas. Otherwise, it would have been able to explore any other area of the New World. Tremendous amount of land, vast land. So when the Spanish arrived here in 1521, they were sent by Queen Isabel and King Ferdinand V to explore this particular area and explore what is today Mexico. They wanted to explore that area too. So they sent a well-known explorer by the name of Hernán Cortés in 1521. He was to arrive from the Gulf of Mexico, come in through what is today the port city of Veracruz, Mexico in 1521, come inland, travel northward, and explore this particular area right here in order to keep the French out and continue exploration. But Hernán Cortés and his 500 men never arrived into this area in 1521, as he was supposed to. Why? As he comes in through the port city of Veracruz, Mexico in 1521, comes inland, now he encounters one of the most advanced civilizations in the New World at that time, the Aztec Empire, whose leader was Montezuma. You can sit down there. I'm giving the history of the missions. Sure. Okay. Sure. So, Hernán Cortés never arrived here. As he comes in through the port city of Veracruz, Mexico in 1521, he encounters one of the most advanced civilizations, which is the Aztec Empire. And Montezuma, leader of the Aztecs. So Hernán Cortés and his 500 men cannot come here to explore and keep the French out. He has to befriend the Aztec people for several months. Now you have to realize this, that as Hernán Cortés arrived with 500 men and he arrives on a white horse, the Aztec people had never seen light-skinned European people before. In their mindset, in their way of thinking 300 years ago, when the Aztec people saw Hernán Cortés and 500 people come in, they thought that they were gods coming in to help and save their civilization. They were experiencing problems, famine, diseases, the water supply was completely drying up for lack of rainfall, and they were dying. So now, Hernán Cortés and his 500 people, the men that he brought with him, now have to befriend Montezuma and the Aztec people. As they befriend them, now they see the gold and the riches that they had. Tremendous amount of gold and riches that they had, and that's what the Spaniards were after the New World. So now Hernán Cortés conspires with his men to kill Montezuma. And they kill Montezuma and his warriors principally for the gold and the riches. As they kill Montezuma, the Aztec people have no leader, they fall apart. The Spanish conquer them. They destroyed the Aztec Empire. They were no match to the Spaniards. They had arms and forces. As they destroyed the Aztec Empire, the Spanish built their buildings on top of the Aztec ruins. And today, they're finding many Aztec ruins underneath these Spanish buildings in what is today Mexico City. Now the Spanish have free reign. Now, Hernán Cortés was very shrewd. He wanted to continue the Spanish conquest of the Americas. Found the gold and the riches in the Aztecs. He figured there'd be other civilizations to conquer for more gold and riches. That's what he was after in the New World. But by that time, the 500 men that he brought with him were already protesting, revolting. They wanted to go back to their homeland. They had enough of the conquest. So what Hernán Cortés does, he assigns